Hello, your call is recorded automatically. Please leave your message after the tone.
In the 1980s, everybody had a clock radio, and clock radios with a built-in telephone were also quite common. But this is the first time I've seen a clock radio telephone with a built-in cassette recorder and answering machine. So they were really trying to do an all-in-one device here by Magnavox. It is the D7549 voice synthesized telephone answering system with electronic clock radio cassette recorder. This is from 1987, and it certainly looks like it. That was the time when electronics had to be various shades of gray, black, and red, as popularized by the Nintendo Entertainment System. Although this one adds an unexpected twist by having a green LED clock display. And also, if you turn on the radio, there's a green LED and a tuning dial to show you where you are on the dial as you're tuning in radio stations. The styling looks even more 1980s from this profile. This grill on the side. I believe on this side it doesn't really do anything, but on the other side, that's where the built-in electric condenser microphone is for the cassette recorder. That side also has the main control switch for all the various functions. On the bottom it has various information stickers. FCC identification sticker by Philips HK Limited, because during this time Magnavox was owned by Philips. It informs us that the telephone is non-hearing aid compatible. And for this backup battery for the alarm, it warns us to only use carbon, zinc, or alkaline batteries. I don't know what other type you would use. Rechargeable? And you can see the telephone portion in the back is almost like a separate unit that they kind of tacked on. So it makes me wonder if they also sold a version of this that did not have the telephone. I did a little searching and discovered that the version without the telephone was the Magnavox D7547. And that version also only had a cassette player. It could not record. As for the telephone, it's nothing special. Very common 1980s style handset. Controls for ringer on and off, pulse and tone dialing. And the hang-up switch is actually in the microphone. So you can hang it up on any flat surface.
A little night music.
The telephone also has a switch in the base of the unit so that if you have the radio on, it mutes when you pick up the telephone. There's the little switch there. Speaking of the radio, let's give it a little sample of how it sounds. Doesn't sound bad, but not quite as good as a General Electric clock radio from the 1980s. Those generally had the best sound quality.
And most importantly for the Jets, Isaiah Crow.
Seems to have pretty good FM reception. Let's try AM.
Said was, look, you've got to reduce this risk, and I mean last week is case in point.
Do is call us up at 1-888-37.
Experience that Cars for Kids guarantees.
Secret private bash for New England Patriots owner Robert Kraft at Gillette Stadium.
Picks up stations on AM pretty good as well, although the sound quality is not the greatest. Now I'm going to test the alarm. It's currently 12:57, and I have the alarm set to go off at 12:58 with the buzzer. So the volume control controls the radio, but not the buzzer. It's probably the largest snooze button I've ever seen. Oh, it doesn't say snooze, it says slumber off or repeat alarm. Because Philips and Magnavox kind of came up with different names for things. Like, instead of sleep, it has slumber, which puts on the radio on for an hour or so. As maybe you can hear, I have the telephone connected to my telephone line, so I'm going to try calling it to hear what the ringer sounds like. Well, that's a very 1980s electronic ringer. And there's a little LED in the handset that flashes when it rings. It has a hands-free mode, which I guess picked up the call. And then when you release the hands-free, it hangs up. Now I'm going to try placing an outgoing call. Put on hands-free.
AT&T customer service. Please hang up and call the toll-free number shown on your bill. For rates, terms, and conditions, or to place a call at the higher operator-assisted rate, please hang up and dial 0 or 00 to reach an operator.
Okay. That was making a telephone call to 1-800-CALL-ATT. Now I'm going to test the answering machine. Put a blank tape in the cassette recorder and you push the button that says answer. It doesn't say record, it says answer. And there's no setting for how many rings it picks up after.
Hello, your call is recorded automatically. Please leave your message after the tone.
Okay, it picked up after the first ring. So I just left my message. It's still running for a little bit, but I think it's going to stop. And it stopped. So to check our messages, you turn the switch on the side to on, which turns on the radio first until you hit play.
Hello, your call is recorded automatically. Please leave your message after the tone.
Okay, it picked up after the first ring. And it gave me that automated greeting from its voice synthesizer. So let's see how this recording turns out. The Magnavox clock radio cassette recorder answering machine from 1987. So not the best sound quality, but it actually works. And it's a very basic answering machine, because if you have it set to answer and then pick up the telephone, it starts recording what's going on the telephone.
So it can be used to record your telephone calls. So this is a sample of me recording what I'm saying into the telephone. Here, I'll play you some touch tone buttons. So you can record your telephone calls with this unit.
As you can see from the buttons on the back, you can also do dictation of the cassette recorder. This is doing dictation with the built-in condenser electric microphone.
This is doing dictation with the built-in condenser electric microphone on the Magnavox clock radio telephone cassette recorder answering machine from 1987. So let's see how this sounds using the built-in microphone.
But if you wanted to make a recording of your favorite piano music station, you seemingly cannot do that on this unit, because I tried all the various combinations of the buttons and switches on this thing, and I could not get it to make a recording from the radio. Of course, it can also be used to play ordinary music cassettes. So I'll give you a little sample of that. Not the best sound quality. But it's really meant for dictation and using it as an answering machine, not necessarily for playing music. I just called this using the modem on my ThinkPad so I could get a direct connection recording of its outgoing greeting on the answering machine. And by the way, there's no way to change that because it's built into the voice synthesizer chip. I don't really know if it's a voice synthesizer or if it's just a really crude digital recording of somebody's voice. Because it sounds natural, doesn't sound like a voice synthesizer. So I'll give you a sample of the best quality recording I can get of that greeting it gives when you call its answering machine.
Hello, your call is recorded automatically. Please leave your message after the tone.
So that's about it for the Magnavox D7549 clock radio telephone cassette recorder answering machine from 1987. It's one of these all-in-one devices that tries to do a lot of things, which doesn't do that great of a job of any of the functions it has, but it's a passable effort, and it certainly would be an interesting device to have in the late 1980s, trying to be at the cutting edge of technology and styling in electronics at that time.